Jen, this isn't just some online spat. The U.S. attorney here in New Hampshire says this suspect caused serious financial harm to Rampant Interactive, and with this indictment, they expect to have him extradited back here to the U.S. to face justice.
Outwar is what's known in the gaming industry as a massive multiplayer online role-playing game. It is published and hosted by Rampant Interactive, a New Hampshire-based company, but it draws players and business from all over the world. U.S. Attorney John Kakavas says in 2007, an Outwar gamer living in the Netherlands became enraged after having his account suspended and hacked into Rampant servers.
He was able to obtain portions of their proprietary source code, and he used that information as leverage to extort some concessions from Rampant, such as, allow me to play Outwar again, and I'll expose to you what your vulnerabilities are.
But Kakavas says Anil Kada, now 24 years old, didn't stop there. The Dutch national and an unindicted co-conspirator in the United Kingdom hacked Rampant servers repeatedly, making it impossible for anyone to play Outwar for days at a time. Authorities say the company incurred losses greater than $100,000. The game's source code, now compromised, represented a $1.5 million investment. Kakavas says Kada turned that information to his own financial advantage.
And created a competitor game called Outcraft using those portions of the source code that he stole.
Kada allegedly made about $10,000 in profits from his pirated version of the game, all while the indictment shows him continually taunting Rampant in online chats, saying things like, pay me $1,500 and you will never hear from me again, and you cannot scare me by calling my mom on the phone.
The U.S. attorney expects Kada to be extradited to the U.S. sometime early next year. We were unfortunately unable to reach Rampant Interactive for comment tonight. It isn't clear if the company still occupies its Portsmouth offices. Its website lists a P.O. box in Derry, though. Reporting live in the newsroom, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.